Oh, come in here for Sunday school and all you do is mess the place up. You, my girl, should be keeping an eye on them, not letting them run riot.
They're not doing any harm. They're just being children.
That may well be. But I'm of the thinking children should be seen and not heard. And as Sunday school teachers, you do well to remember that.
Come and sit down, children.
Is that true what Mrs. Little said?
No, of course not. It's just, sometimes adults forget what it was like to be children.
I don't think I want to grow up.
I don't think you'll have much choice. But what you can do is make sure you never lose your childlike way of looking at the world. Yes, Jesus was very particular about that. And in Mark's Gospel, he writes, "And they brought young children to him so that he should bless them. And the disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, Suffer the little children that come unto me and forbid them not. For of such is the kingdom of heaven. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein."
So does anybody serve Jesus?
Yes, as long as your heart is right.
Everybody down. Friends, I welcome you to this Salvation Army House of God. As most of you know, next week we shall have the visit of the Divisional Commander.
Yes.
And his wife, Major Happy Sustainter. It's going to be a big event in the Corps. Now, the children have a special song. And so have we. God's love for us is as high as the sky. Come on, let's sing.
Thank you.
well for many months now, Dad Briggs has been concerned about his daughter up in London. We're praising God tonight because they've been reunited. I thought it would be very nice if we asked Dad Briggs to give his testimony. So here he is. I know you will listen. I know you will listen very carefully. God bless you, Dad.
Thank you. Well, my heart is so full as I stand here tonight with my dear daughter Mary. I thank God for bringing her safely back to me. Dear Treasurer Luke had been up to London to a big meeting where he got the glory in his soul. And as he was walking back along the Strand for his train, who should he see standing there in the street with all them other poor girls but our Mary? I couldn't have blamed him if he'd hurried on past. I mean, a respectable man like him. But he remembered, bless him, he remembered that I said to him, if ever he should see my Mary, he was to give her my love. Mary, I can't go on.
I'll tell you. He taps me on the arm as Treasurer Luke and says, Mary, only last night your father said to me that if I saw you, I was to tell you that he loved you. You don't mean it, Mr. Luke, I said. I do, Mary. He wants you home more than anything in life. He's old, poor and ill, Mary. Come home with me now to him. Come home, I said. What? Like this? Mary, we're at the station. Let me buy you a ticket and take you home. You can't mean it, I said. He meant it. He bought me a ticket. He bought me home to my dad. And with God in my life, I promise to be a better girl.
Amen. Amen.
Glory!
Amen.
Then I come to the fox and hound.
I started climbing the steps. My hand was on the door handle. The draw was irresistible. The smell of the beer was in my nostrils. And I tried the name. Jesus, Jesus glory, I said. And I fled as if the devil had said.
Joe at all. Do you think he's mind, ought I to have the doctor in?
But Mrs. Little, it's you!
Me?
You are to blame! Have you ever thought about your determination to always have your own way? To brook no denial? To have your husband always under the thumb, maybe the cause? All these years you've been taking advantage of his quiet disposition, making his life one long giving way to you. The Holy Spirit is giving him some backbone, and you don't like it.
Well, I'm trying.
Now don't interrupt me. I listen to you, now you listen to me. Yes, yes, that's just it. You can speak, but nobody else can say a word. Now you listen to me now. Coming to the army is making a man out of your husband. I know, I've seen a thing or two. Blethering on in the meeting about not letting your husband come out on a Friday night, it's a disgrace. I'd be mightily ashamed of myself and my wife too if she'd said such a thing. And you know I'm weak enough. A man needs to be master in his own house. It's your temper, Mrs. Little. Don't talk to me about doctors. It's the great physician you need. Come, sister, let's pray about it.
Me? Pray with you? I wouldn't demean myself. You've insulted me. You have the nerve to tell me it's my temper. How dare you? I never want to speak to you again or come to that army of yours. You're driving my husband crazy with your hypocrisy. A man must be his own master, must he? Well, not in my house, let me tell you. Be master in your own before you start filling my husband with such rubbish. You, pray with me, never. I'd wipe the floor with you first. And you can get yourself a new hallkeeper too.
This blessing of a clean heart, which you spoke about yesterday morning. I ain't satisfied with the way things are, and nor is my Sally. I'm in the habit of being awfully touchy with young Bob, and just now, when a child threw some rubbish in your basket, I want to clam round the head. I know it's not right, I know it's not Salvation Army, let alone Jesus Christ, and I've got to get rid of all that. Is that what they mean by the song, Captain? Let nothing unholy remain?
Well, this is hardly the place or the time, Bob, for this kind of discussion. But yes, that's just what I meant. Given half the chance, the Holy Spirit could do a thorough good job in you. He's faithful and just, not only to forgive us our sins, but to cleanse us. That's it, Bob, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Do you really mean to say that a man, a working chap like me, can be kept free from sin? No, that's a bit too much. Can't take that. Well, it says in the Bible, and I know I've read it myself, that if we say we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves. I asked Reverend Barber what it meant, and he said it meant what it says, Captain, and he ought to know.
But Bob, it's in the same chapters I've just read. If we confess our sin, he's faithful and just, not only to forgive us, but to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's a phrase, Bob. All unrighteousness. Be logical. Do you think I'd want a Holy Spirit who can only keep picking picking me up and not stop me from tripping over. That Saviour wouldn't do for me.
From all sin.
From all sin.
From all sin. From all sin. Not me, surely. Oh, Fishbowl, to cleanse from all unrighteousness, me.
Here, Captain. What's the matter with him?
There's nothing wrong with him. He's getting the blessing, that's all.
Lord, if it's in the Bible, then I believe it. It's true what the captain said. You didn't come to me to make half a job of it. Lord, it's from all sin. All sin, here and now.
If we say that we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves, it's true. But when we own our sin and then disown our sin, the work of grace begins.
Flag!
Beautiful flag!
I don't
plotting to steal your flag. So, I have done a bit of plotting myself. And, during the scuffle, what a disgraceful business. During that scuffle, I managed to slip the flag from the pole. And I'm allowed to...
Oh,
there is a
He's Fred. He's dead.
Oh, God rest his soul.
But he said the strangest thing, Captain, before he died. I didn't understand it.
Tell me, Joe, what did he say?
He said, 17 times, but it's victory now. That's what he said, Captain. 17 times, but it's victory now. I mean, what did he mean? Don't you see? Don't you understand?
Fred came to the mercy seat 17 times before he was really saved.
17 times. But it's victory now. That makes sense right enough. That was Fred's final testimony. Oh, praise God, praise God.
Please, would you pray with me?
I'll pray with you. Let's make this table the mercy seat and we'll seek the Lord together.
Was the best thing that's ever happened to the town. Yes. I don't know why they have to go.
Headquarters is always making daft decisions.
Yes. That the Lord had a hand in it somewhere. Yes, amen. But they're going to do the Lord's work elsewhere, and we're here now to say thank you, goodbye, and God bless you. And Fishbox, going to have a word.
Friends, I thank God that Captain and Mrs. Campbell ever came this way.
Yes, amen.
Do you remember when they first arrived with the little ones, and we met them down at the quay?
Yes.
And we wondered what would happen when the army came to town.
Yes.
Excuse me, Sergeant Major, I've got a word to say. On behalf of the Temperance Society of this town, I would like to say God bless you, Captain and Mrs. Campbell, and may God use you in your new appointment. Your ministry in this town will never be forgotten.
Thank you. Well, the
Lord led us here. I'm sure of that. Oh, don't cry. Lucy, love, don't cry. And as I look around, my heart fills with gratitude for what God has done in his past 12 months.
Amen.
What he's done for Fishbolt there.
Yes.
And for Tom.
Yes. Amen.
And for Lady Beatrice.
Yes. Bless her.
And for Jesse.
Yes.
And for Dad Briggs.
And for me, Captain, and for me. The Lord's done a work of grace in me.
Year, busy for us, and busy for the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
But there's one small announcement I'd just like to make. Fishbolt Jr. here, and by the way, doesn't he look smart in his new
uniform? Yes,
Fishbolt Jr. here, and our Jesse are getting married under the blood and fire of the
God help them, that's what I say.
Ago, but there's one song that we've grown to love more than any other. So let's sing it before we go to remind ourselves of what God has done for us. Glory!
Laughing, laughing. Thank you.